Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can use Stable Diffusion. Today will be about the flux model, and you can generate images while you are displaying or showcasing a product. So imagine that you have a product. It's a physical product that you can hold, you can take a picture of, and you import it on your computer, load a ComfyUI workflow, and let me show you an example here. It's automatically going to generate, in this particular case, a person holding a bag, and this bag is a real bag, as you can see here. All I'm doing is adding some kind of person background so that that particular product is being displayed. So this is an example of just showcasing a bag. I have another one here, and you may recognize this t-shirt here from a previous video. So I have a video here where I was wearing that t-shirt. All I did was to take a picture of the t-shirt, place it in the workflow here, and it went ahead and generated a person wearing that t-shirt. I've also described the background, the atmosphere, and that's why you have the rest of it. But basically, we now have a model wearing your product. So that's what you can do with this particular workflow. I've also added a refiner to it where it's going to add a little bit extra in case the face, hand, or you need extra detail in the final output. So I'm going to talk about the workflow today. Let's take one more example. And let me show you the workflow here. So right now I'm pretending to have a wig or like some kind of hair dye that I will be selling online. So I can take a picture of that wig, place it here, and it's going to generate different faces, different people, depending on your prompt, and then make those people wear that product. So in this particular case, I'm just wearing the wig, as you can see from this final generation here. Have a couple of examples here. So this is the example that I've showcased there. So right now, this is the input image. If I take it and place it on top of the character, you can see it's a 100% fit. And if you have logos on your product, as long as it's not on the edge, if it's in the middle of that input image, it's going to stay there 100%. It's going to transfer it. If it's on the edge, so as you can see here, it depends on the masking that's going to happen. If the mask is like what I'm doing here, like a really bad job, a quick job, just masking really quickly, then you will get these fringes. We have like a black outline that hopefully you can see it on the video here, but that's going to get corrected by the model. So when I place it here, you can see that we no longer have those fringes, the black outline. So if you do a good job at masking, you can preserve logos which are on the edge of the product. But if you can take an image or picture of your product where the logo is more or less on the inside, then it's going to get transferred 100%. So the same thing here, this one has the model got a little bit more flexibility. So that is also available. As you can see, the general outline is the same, and even the hair, the color is the same. It's just that a little bit more flexibility there. This one is another example. So same thing, we have different person, and as long as the product is some kind of unisex product, you can place it on man or women. Here's another one where I'm changing the ethnicity of the person. So we have like an African person here, a white person. I think these are Japanese, and this one is cool. This is the same wig, right? The same hair, but for this one, I'm doing short hair, and this one I'm doing long hair. So even though my input image is a short hair, the AI is able to generate the long hair based on that input image. This one was a little bit more difficult because I had only part of the product, and it's still, it's able to generate, as you can see, it's like we're playing Lego. It's getting attached to the image. Now, your product does not need to be like this, where we have the hair, have bottles there, You've seen a bag, you've seen a t-shirt. It can also be, I don't want to say like a person as a product, but what we are doing here is that one section of the image is staying static. So in this particular case, I have the person stay static and it's just changing the hair. So this person is the same person in all three images here. So these three images, and I'm just changing the hairstyle. So you will be able to do this with this workflow as well. And here's a bottle. This one is without any input image. When I pass this input image, this is the product. It's able to transfer the product to any background that I wanted while also generating the reflections or shadows that would come. So in this case, we have the shadow. We also have the reflection here. This one, we have the reflection because I asked for water in the background. And this is just the bag that I've showed you in this particular case. So it's the exact same bag, but in this one, I wanted a person to hold it. And I think I also asked for a red dress. Yes. And you can see it gives us the bag and the person holding the bag. This is just the refiner. So let's go through the workflow. In the description of this video, you will get a context inpainting workflow.json file. So all you need to do is to grab the, download it, save it somewhere, drag it on top of ConfigUI, release, and it's going to load the workflow. Now, sometimes when you load workflows, it gets complicated and you don't know where to start. So for this particular workflow, all you need to do is to start from the left side, right? And then you move horizontally like this to the right side. Once you've reached the end, you go back to the left side and then you keep on doing this patterns. Okay, so starting with the top here, we have a section for connection. And in this particular section, you don't have to do anything. I've already set up everything. Well, the only thing that you can change actually would be the upscale method. And you can select it from the dropdown. You can also change the keep proportion to false if you want that, but I've already set it up so that the proportion is maintained and it's going to resize to a 1024 by 1024. If your picture is your image, your input image needs to be in a portrait mode, it's automatically going to calculate the shorter side. So there's no need to mess with these. If you know what you're doing, go ahead, change some values. Otherwise, you just need to go into the next section where we have the loaders. And in this workflow, I'm actually using the Flux Fill Dev FP8. And later for the refiner stage, I'm also using this Flux 0.1 Dev FP8. You will need to download these two models and then place it in the correct directory. I will have these links in the description below. Select the one that you'd like to use depending on the amount of VRAM that you have. If you have 24 gigabytes, then go with the Fill Dev one. If you have anything less, go with the FP8 version. So once you click on the link, it's going to bring you to Hugging Face page. And the only thing you need to do here is to click on this download button, wait for it to complete the download. Once your download is completed, then you just need to go into ConfigUI, look for the models folder, go inside it, and go inside diffusion models, and then place that Fill Dev FP8 or the full version here. In case you have any confusion on Flux, or if this is your first time with the Flux model, I have multiple videos on the channel. Latest one is this one. But if you go a little bit down, you will see this video here where I explain all the different versions of the Flux model and where to place them. I also share the workflows which contain nodes. And in those nodes section, it will tell you where to place the models file that you'll be downloading. And you can keep on scrolling down. I have other videos on how to use Flux. This one here is the one that explain about the FP8, and these two here explain about the full version of Flux. And in case you're downloading the full version, the 24 gigabytes one, it will take you to Hugging Face page first, where you will need to click here where it says files and version, and it will take you to this page, and then you will need to click here where we have the download version. As you can see, this one is 24 gigabytes. There's also the VAE here in case you do not have it. But if you've used the Flux model before, you should have everything except the fill one, unless you've already tried that. Now back to the workflow, it's actually very easy to understand. We'll always do left to right and then top to bottom when we read the workflow. So we've already done this. Make sure that you go into your config UI. At the top here, we have edit, and then click on refresh node definition. It will tell you here that the nodes are being refreshed, and then you can go into the individual node, click on it, and then select it from the drop-down list. Sometimes the name will be different, like this one here. We have .save tensors. That was a mistake on my part. I went back, rename it, and now if I were to click on Qprompt, it will tell me that the model does not exist or the model is missing. So I'll need to click on this drop-down and then select the correct model here. Okay, you'll do this for each one here. This here is going to be the input image. It can be anything. In this particular case, I'm again using this hair wig as an example, but you can place a bottle here, you can place a bag. If you have a lamp, you can take a picture and put it here. Next, you will need to right click on the image and then go into open in mask editor. It will open the image and then you will need to draw over the area that you want to generate, not your product. Okay, so this is the product, you will leave it intact. Everything else that you don't want to see in that final image that you will draw on, you can use this thickness slider to get your brush. And if I change this to white here, you can see that I've already drawn the mask. Click on save once you're done. This is going to be your resolution. We have width and height. Right now it's already at 1024. All right, so here is where you're going to put your positive prompt. This is going to be what you want to see in the final image. In this particular case, I'm using a woman because I want to see a woman. This is a wig of a woman. There is a refiner section where you can describe more things that you want to see. So if you want to see like accessories, you can use that refiner section, which will be here. And as you can see here, I have a more descriptive prompt. Now, this is going to be the seed. And right now, you can click on this new fix random seed. And you can also change this from random to fix if you are experimenting and trying to see what is going to be the initial image that you'll get from the inpainting section. Now, the rest, you should be leaving it as it is because these bottom nodes are only for the connection. All right, so we've reached the end here. So like I said, we go from left to right and then top to down. So right now we go down and we'll start from the left side, top left. So these are just the connection. We go directly into the key sampler. From here, you can change the number of steps. Now, because I will be using the Flux Refiner section, I have it at 5 steps. This means that it will only generate the overall outline and not really have any detail. So I have the screenshot here. It's the same workflow, by the way. I have it at 5. As you can see here, we don't have a lot of detail. And this is the true size of the image. It's 1024 by 1024. You can see that it looks pixelated at this stage. And that's just because of the 5 steps. But here's an example of the number of steps in the inpainting section being 20. You can see that we have the person already detailed out. This is the example of the bag, the background as well. So when we go into the refiner section here, it does not change a lot in the final section. It's only clearing the floor. We have a little bit more detail in the face compared to this one. But if you want to influence or to sort of improve, add more detail, then you want to keep these number of steps at 5. It will give you some kind of pixelated image when you zoom in, but then you can go into the refiner section. Make sure here from the dropdown, you are selecting the FluxPoint 1 Dev FP8. This is the load checkpoint. So I am using the Comfy Org version, not the Kijai version. if you only have the Kijai version, then you will need to replace this with the top section, like this, where you have load diffusion, dual clip loader, and load VE separately. All right, so once you have your model, make sure that you are changing your prop. This particular case, I have a detailed prop. Well, relatively detailed compared to the previous prop because I'm using only the 5 steps. And then it goes into the case sampler as usual, and we get a higher quality of that that final generation. Even the cloth here, if you compare it, this one doesn't have any detail, but this one has detail. So if you want to leave room to be flexible in your final generation so that you can add more things in here, then you want this number of steps here in the in-painting section to be low. I've tried with lower number of steps. It did not work well. So 5 was the minimum that I was able to go. Depending on the product that you're trying to display or showcase, you may be able to go even lower than this. Leave that field for experimentation if you want to. But yes, that's about it. And like I mentioned, the workflow will be available in the description below. If you click on the download link, it shows you something like this where you have only the code. Then you will need to right click on the page and then select save or save as, depending on your browser. And then just give it a name and save it somewhere. I would like to take a moment to thank these amazing people supporting the channel on Patreon. And as a way to show appreciation to all of you, I will have a couple of workflows on Patreon page. And those workflows will contain things like this, where you have notes explaining each section, what they do. So you can use these workflows to accompany with the video. So I will also have a auto masking workflow that you can use. So instead of masking it automatically, it's going to be like this. And you will see notes like this where it's going to tell you what are the best practices to use it. And in case you have like complicated input image and this specific auto masking is not working, I will also have a separate workflow that's just about masking, where you can select individual part of your image. So in this case, as you can see, the auto masking is selecting the entire character. But with this specific workflow, you can select the hair, the jacket, and stuff like that. And finally, I will also be sharing this variation of today's workflow. And this one will give you more control, and it will ensure that the entire product is transferred over to the final image. And it's going to be the exact product. Even the edge of that product will be transferred correctly. So if you have any kind of watermark or logo that is on the edge, and then the first workflow is not really working because of that in-painting, and we have a mask padding there, this one will work and will be able to transfer it correctly. All right, so you can grab all of this from the Patreon. By the way, you only need to be on the first tier. So if you are on the other 2 tier, you will be eligible to get those workflows. And if you're new and you have the means to support the channel, I will have a link to the Patreon page in the description below. If you would like to get these extra content, the additional workflows, it's going to be $3 per month, and it's just the first tier. If you need additional help, then I will have video explaining the workflows. This will be in the second tier. The third tier for exclusive content and first expression videos. So whenever I'm testing out a new application, I will record myself, my reaction, and then it's going to be posted over there. All right, so thank you for watching until the very end. For the majority of you not on Patreon, the download link will take you to GitHub, where you will get the workflow, the .json file, plus you will also get an input image, which I've already masked. So you can use that as an example to mask out your own product. You can also drag it inside the workflow. And since it already has a mask in it, you just need to click on the cue prompt to test out. All right then, so take care, have a nice day, and I will see you next time.